What is the Scottish Rite? You may ask at the outset, what is the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry? I am constrained to reply, like the wit, that it is impossible to think about when you come to think about it. I can tell you first what it is not. It is not the formal organization, nor is it our magnificent temples, nor is it a severely secret society, nor is it merely ritual. Perhaps we should content ourselves with the standard definition of Masonry that it is a peculiar system of morality, veiled in allegory and illustrated by symbols. Our overall mission can be summarized thus: to seek that which is the most worth in the world, to exalt the dignity of every person, the human side of our daily activities, and the maximum service to humanity, to aid in mankind's search in God's universe for identity, for development, and for destiny, and thereby achieve better men in a better world, happier men in a happier world, and wiser men in a wiser world. Our ultimate goal, simply stated, is mankind's moral and spiritual and intellectual development. Historically, the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry as we know it evolved as the Rite of Perfection over 200 years ago on the continent of Europe, under the constitutions of 1762. Later, the Grand Constitutions of 1786 were enacted and became the creative and derivative laws for us and all our descendants, supreme councils of the ancient and accepted Scottish Rite. Our Supreme Council was organized at Charleston, South Carolina in 1801 as the Mother Supreme Council of the world, and hence, all regular and recognized Supreme Councils throughout the world must trace their pedigree to us. But the actual roots of the Scottish Rite go far deeper. Tracing them is a romantic and exciting quest for adventure in the realm of the mind and the spirit. It is a superb story of success, more intriguing than the storied search for the Holy Grail and more rewarding than a successful probe for the Philosopher's Stone. Our teachings and symbols preceded our formal organization by thousands of years. They go deep into ancient ages. The signs, symbols, and inscriptions come to us from across long, drifting centuries, and will be found in the tombs and temples of India, to those of Nubia, through the valley of the Nile in Egypt, down to its delta, as well as in what was then known as Chaldea, Assyria, Persia, Greece, Rome, and even in Mexico and Yucatan. The Scottish Rite, therefore, is a treasure house in which there is stored the ageless essence of immutable laws, the accumulation of thousands of years of Masonic experience. We learn our mission in a system of progressive degrees of instruction. We teach our members the highest ethics, the wise expositions of philosophy and religion, the blessings of charity. Our code of personal conduct stems from the precepts of chivalry, the Ten Commandments, and the Golden Rule. We reveal truly the wisdom of the lesser and greater mysteries, and their symbols of words and phrases long considered lost. These were the truths that Plato, Pythagoras, Socrates, Homer, and other intellects of the ages held in high esteem, that have reappeared in later religions, and that never were disclosed until after timely preparation and purification of selected and trusted initiates. Our degrees represent the study and reflection of many men during many years and at heavy cost, the culling of hundreds of volumes for effective portrayals and illustrations, and more labor than the accumulated endeavors of a lifetime engaged in efforts to attain eminence or riches. Our members therefore receive a gift of the greatest value. They gain a comprehensive knowledge of our heritage, of history, philosophy, religion, morality, freedom, and toleration, and of their relationship to their creator, their country, their family, and themselves. These will may lead also to that understanding of identity, clarity of mind and energy of will that propel toward personal success in life. We carry out our mission in a series of spiritual, charitable, and moral programs. We make living, breathing, vital parts of our activities the recovery and maintenance of moral standards and spiritual values, the pride of patriotism and love of flag and country, the dispensing of charity without regard to race, color, or creed. Our Scottish Rite Hospital for Crippled Children at Atlanta was the forerunner of the vast chain of shrine hospitals across the nation. We stand for positive programs, but fight with moral courage and enthusiasm every force or power that would seek to destroy freedom, including spiritual despotism and political tyranny. We believe and teach that sovereignty of the state resides in control by the people themselves, and not in some self-appointed dictator or despotic totalitarian. We therefore advocate complete separation of church and state, absolute freedom of and protection of religion, press and assembly, and the dignity of every individual. those we consider vital for the ultimate liberties and independence of our people. Ours, therefore, has been a strong voice for human dignity, political justice, moral values, and civic responsibility. Through our teachings, millions of men and women have discovered an opportunity to lead more rewarding lives. The example of our actions has been as stirring and inspiring as that of our collective commitment to true human progress. Today, our mother jurisdiction, of which I am Sovereign Grand Commander, includes 35 of our United States and all our territories and possessions abroad. Of the 4 million Masons in the United States, there are over a million Scottish Rite members. Our mother jurisdiction comprises more than 660,000 members who belong to so-called valleys and 218 cities. We have clubs and many more. They meet frequently for executive, administrative, and evangelistic purposes, as provided by our statutes. Their control and management is under elected officers who, in turn, are supervised by our Inspector General or deputies. The Inspectors General of our mother jurisdiction, now numbering 30, meet as our Supreme Council every 2 years in a session over which I preside. When it is not in session, I discharge the functions of our Supreme Council in pursuance of our statutes. Our House of the Temple in Washington, an awe-inspiring monumental structure, is the nerve center of our organization. We also have at our headquarters the department heads, administrative branches, and staff. These include our world-famed Grand Secretary, Director of Education, and Managing Editor of The New Age, our monthly magazine. I must say a word also as to membership in our order. We welcome and initiate inquiries from Master Masons of regular and recognized lodges. Thereby, we grow and expand the light. Our officers and committees devote long hours in evaluating and deciding upon those we feel should progress beyond the screening process and become entitled to pass through the mystic gate of Scottish Rite Masonry. All who seek entry are commended for their interest and vision. Sponsorship and standards of character, morality, and training are required, of course, but every candidate will receive serious consideration. Thus, we assure compliance with our time-tested standards and selection process. A new member is made welcome and invited to participate in our activities. And so, to end as we started, when we sought a definition, to me, the Scottish Rite can be likened to a tree of sparkling symbolic jewels, surmounted with a blazing star of truth that displays the dazzling splendor of the mystic doctrines of the universe and the reflected glory of the deity. Hence, inspired by our accomplishments of the past and encouraged by our endeavors of the present, we go on to even more monumental achievements in the great tomorrow, toward our greater Scottish Rite destiny.